Miroslav, we're talking about encryption. Encryption has become extremely important over the last few years. So when we talk about encryption, why is it so relevant? Can you explain a little bit more details on that subject?
Well, paging encryption is very relevant now because POCSAC, a paging protocol, was developed in the early 70s. At that time, security was not so relevant as today. And for example, a radio technician with a certain technical skills can easily eavesdrop a POCSAC. It can record POCSAC protocol, it can decode it and publish, for example, the messages on the internet. And if a message like this one contains very sensitive patient data, that it can become a legal issue. And that's because Swissphone decided already 25 years ago to offer end-to-end encryption in their paging systems.
Okay, if you talk about end-to-end, what exactly do you mean with end-to-end solution?
Well, end-to-end means that the information is readable only from the both ends of communication channel. So in our example, we have on the left side, we have command and control system with a dispatcher. And on the right side, we have, for example, emergency medical doctor who is mm-hmm. a recipient of the information. And end-to-end means also that the message is encrypted in a command and control system. Swissphone provides for this purpose certain software libraries which can be easily integrated in command and control system. And then message is transferred in encrypted way through the system to the pager. And upon arrival on a pager, message is encrypted and shown to the responder. So that means also that no one between command and control system and the pager can read the message because it is encrypted. And for the encryption, paging Swissphone uses IDEA encryption protocol. IDEA is an encryption protocol which is developed in Switzerland on a university in Switzerland, in Zurich, in 1991, and Swissphone just uses this protocol for message encryption. And IDEA is a symmetrical paging protocol. That means that the same key is used for a message encryption in command and control system and also for message description decryption in the pager. And IDEA uses a key length of 128 bits.
Okay. If we talk about 128 bits, is that enough nowadays? Because I can remember, you know, if you have a very powerful computer, it's very easy to hack 128 bits. Or am I totally wrong?
Well, yes, 120 bits is enough today. It's more than enough, actually. And I will show you why. So, okay. What does it mean, the key length of 128 bits? So that means that we have 2 to the power of 128 different key combination. And this is a huge number. I can even don't know how to read this number.
I can see a very large number on the screen.
It's so very large. It's about 39 digits. And so that means that the attacker has go through all this key combination and try to decode the message with each key and see if the message is readable. And you are also correct. Nowadays, we have very powerful computers. Let us take, for example, the current Bitcoin network, which is used for mining of a cryptocurrency Bitcoin. This network is extremely powerful. It consists of thousands of computers which are spread around the world and are interconnected. And the power of this computer network is expressed in hashes per second. And this network can check 16 million tera hashes in second. So that means that IDEA attacker could use this network and check 16 million tera keys in only 1 second. But what does it mean? A time which is needed to crack the key, you should just divide the key length through the Bitcoin hash rate and you will get the number of seconds which are needed to go through all key combination and try to crack the key. And this time, just to make a comparison, we can compare this time with, for example, age of the universe. Our universe is 13.8 billion years old, and if we express 13.8 billion in a seconds, you will get also extremely huge number. But comparing to the time to needed to crack the key, we see that this time is even larger than the age of the universe. Indeed, you would need 30 times the age of the universe with this computer network to go through all key combinations and try to crack the key. So that means that 128 bits are much more than enough secure.
Okay, that's all clear, Miroslav. Now, but what is the advantage of IDEA in relationship to other possible technologies? Because I guess there are some other technologies as well.
Yes, there are some advantages of IDEA encryption protocol. One of the advantages is that IDEA has very little security overhead. So that means that encrypted message is only 40 bits longer than a plain text message. So let me show this on the following slide. Mm-hmm. Well, IDEA, like other symmetrical encryption algorithms, has a characteristic that the length of the plain text message and encrypted text message should be the same. But this is only theory. In reality, all paging system supplier implement some add-ons in IDEA, some additionals which extend the length of the encrypted message. Add-ons such, for example, is time authentication or compatibility for the transfer to the paging system. And all those add-ons increase the length of the encrypted message. If you increase the length of the encrypted message, then you will also increase the time which is needed to alert responders. So the IDEA has a characteristic that it has a very little overhead, only 40 bits, only 2 POXA code words per message. So this is one of the IDEA advantages.
Miroslav, I understand that's one of the advantages, but I guess there are some more advantages towards that encryption.
Yes,
am
this
I right?
Yes, this is correct. There are some more advantages, but let me make at first the short summary.
Okay.
So we can see it on this slide. So one advantage is this end-to-end encryption. So Swissphone implementation of IDEA makes possible easy integration in command and control system. The second thing is the key length of 128 bits. So we have seen that this provides very high security level. The third is a very little security overhead of only 40 bits per message. And then also the encrypted paging message is also optimized for the transfer through the paging system. So once you have encrypted the message, you have to encode it, the message, with the character set which is supported by paging system. And Swissphone implementation of IDEA uses POXAC numerical character set, which is optimized, and there is no additional overhead due to this conversion. The next thing is that IDEA is error safe. POXAC is a radio protocol, and during radio propagation, many errors can occur during radio interferences or other distortion in the reception. But IDEA is very error safe because only 2 code words of IDEA must be error free for pager to be able to display the whole message. So this is one of the strengths of the IDEA encryption protocol. And of course, last but not least, just to be said, is that Swissphone has implemented IDEA since 25 years in more than 100 paging network internationally.